Welcome back, guys, to the next episode of Pokemon Desolation. In the last episode, we made our way out of Redcliffe Town after battling Connor, and we faced off with, I believe it's Team Crescent. I'm almost positive that's what happened in the cave. I'm still getting used to the name, so I hope I didn't get it wrong, but that's pretty much what we did. So not too much. This episode, I'm going to try and do the side quests for this little ranger skill. So yeah, there's not much to say. If you guys are enjoying the playthrough, please leave a like, comment down below, subscribe for more, and let's begin. You're useless. Trash. Horrible. Gross. Really. Wow. I bet your brain is as good as new, considering you've never used it. You're such a useless brick, Lucas. Still better than you, loser. Dan, are you gonna let him sit around and talk like this? Ugh. Bugger off, Senna. Your drama ain't my problem. Ugh, thanks for nothing, idiot. Damn it, Lucas. This wouldn't be an issue if you'd done all your jobs. It's not my fault there's way too many for me to handle. Can't you hush for a second? Can't you see there's a visitor? Sorry. Okay. It was his fault. I'm really sorry. Look, I'm a bit busy. If you don't mind, could you, shoot? Goodness me, how embarrassing. I apologize for their behavior. Everyone is a bit stressed due to the volume of our work. Oh, where are my manners? Welcome, trainer, to the Rangers Guild. My name is Elliot, and I am in charge of this merry little bunch. The Rangers Guild is an organization spread across Iris that dedicates itself to helping anyone and everyone in need. We get requested for help, then these requests are handed amongst the Rangers. When a Ranger completes a task, they get rewarded. The rewards are then handed over at the top desk. Although with the state of things, there's been far too many jobs for us to handle. It's even worse than the Celia City branch. Rumors are they may have been shut down. We really could have used a hand. You look pretty strong, trainer. Are you perhaps interested in joining? Yeah. Great. I didn't think a volunteer would just jump out like this. Go chat to the other Rangers. Get some jobs. When you have enough experience, come talk to me again. New member? Wow, go do some jobs. You can learn loads of credits being a ranger. Okay. This is this thing already. Yeah, there we go. Name's Dan. They put me in charge of jobs that require some brawn. It's usually battles or helping people being attacked by wild Pokemon. Hit me up if you want a job, alright? Make sure your team is tough for these, okay? Troublemaker, rough Pokemon, I need help. Okay, that's good. There's some punk causing a lot of trouble around here, battling everyone who comes through. Naturally, he's going to wipe out little kids, but that's just plain sad. You're a ranger, so you should be more than enough to show him up. One credit? There'll be somewhere here in our glade somewhere. Alright. Wait, can I accept more than one? Okay. That's helpful. Imagine if I tried to do one of these one by one. Lost and found? Oh crap, there's quite a lot of these. Let's just unlock them all, and then I'll go down the list as I do them. My Ponyta is lost. Find my Trubbish. Since it's all being added to the quest log, I actually don't have to read all this, so it's nice. Definitely a convenient way of doing things. You need permission from the Celeste City Gym Leader to enter the depths, so go talk to her if you haven't already. Okay. So that's the one I'm gonna have to go speak to the gym leader about. Super. Alright. Now that we got that done, we need to look around for the troublemaker. Oh, it's this doofus. He sends out a level 22 attack. Man, don't get it. Gumshoes. Mm-hmm. have a fighting type. No way I would say this. You'll have a rematch with me. You wait. All right, that was Troublemaker. All right, neat. Let's just. Who am I replacing for? An electric type. I feel like Cast Form is kind of OP this early on. Maybe Krogan. Because everyone else is just really good. Probably Krogunk. Krogunk is probably the worst Pokemon I could have right now. Alright. I guess what we'll have to do is explore the area. There's a Lillipup over there. Oh, it's a wild Lillipup. I mean, Stoutland's not a bad Pokemon, honestly, if I'm being honest with you. Okay, so that was, Alright, I guess I gotta go into the city to see if I can find more of these quests. Convince the trainers. Hey Sora, thanks for that really fun battle earlier. I'm just gonna relax a bit. Catching and training my new friends was really tiring. Hey, this might seem a little weird, but I think I've been thinking a lot lately about what that girl Nova said earlier. I don't know, she said that each of us have the potential to change the world, right? But, you know, how am I meant to help? I mean, I'm not even a strong battler. Do you really think she's right? Do you really think any of us can just, you know, fix the world if we put our minds to it? Yeah, of course you're right. I need to stop being such a pessimist, huh? I mean, I'm sure Ava would disagree, but I'm sure Ava would disagree, but it's hope that really keeps us going, right? Wait, did I lose points? What was that in red? I just need to keep training harder. Eventually, I can make a difference, right? Hey, I'm sure you have more important things to do than hanging out with me, right? I mean, if you're just gonna say it, I do. Maintain gaming PC and flowers at the same time. Fabulous, aren't you? Game review. A weird guy came through earlier, definitely not a local. Weirdest part was that his only Pokemon was the Aipom. Oh, they're talking about what's his name? Shin. They're talking about Shiv. My brother left the greener for greener pastures a while ago. I really miss him. Okay. Roly Poly. And he traded for Elekid. Machop, Slowpoke, Cacnea. Interesting. facade. At this point, I'm just accepting fucking quests. Oh, we're all the way up here. Jeez. Fair enough. Reverse candy. I didn't think. I mean, I guess it makes sense. Oh, here's a rubbish. Alright, nice. I think this is this person's house, right? Someone here? You can't see me. Huh? It's been even longer since I battled someone, but that doesn't matter. Sorry to bother you, trainer. Take this. Oh, that's a good item. Damn, and I was just like, I'm probably going to take Krogonk off my team. Now I kind of don't want to, even though he doesn't really have that many good fighting type moves. Revenge is like mid. But it's not bad, it's like, okay. You can't convince me to go back there. Huh? You're here trying to get me back into the game? Damn it, y'all never learn to quit. I'll admit though, Lucas was always one of the best ones, you know? Fine, I don't have to think about it. Could you find me a lemonade or something in the meantime? Okay, what the fuck? Where am I supposed to get him some lemonade? House is locked. Enter the house directly to the right of the Pokemon Center. Oh. Why the fuck do they have a vending machine in their house? Oddly, like, you know what? I don't even care. I didn't have to go far for it. I think that matters the most. Alright. That one's done. Oh, hi. You don't look a familiar face here. You must be a trainer then. Well, I'll be honest. I've been looking for a trainer all along. You see, my house serves as a Celeste library. But there's one particular book I'd love to get my hands on, but it's located in the Weaving Depths. No way am I going down there. Maybe you could find it for me? Yeah, sure. Appreciate this. I can't go into the depths, though, until I get permission from the gym leader. I'm not sure if that means I have to beat the gym first, but it's possible. I really want a Pokemon, but my mom won't let me have one. That's tough. I left my friend on route 2. How foolish of me. Of course, the life of a celebrity is most difficult. Perhaps I should go find him. That's a real spiel. Kinda just hoping to cast form sweep though. Ah, Sora! I shouldn't be surprised to see you here. So you found me, huh? I suppose you come for a gym battle then. Oh. I see. Being from these parts isn't intentional. My apologies. I should have given you the chance to explain your plight. Unfortunately, Crescent has caused just as many problems for me as they have for you, I'm afraid. So you wish to take a plane to fly to Cecilia, hmm? Of course I'd be happy to help you and your friends, but unfortunately you'd be out of luck at the moment. Currently our only plane is delivering a shipment of spice powder to Cecilia. I would fly you home myself, but times are quite desperate with everything that Crescent is doing. Unfortunately, Sora, my city needs me. I believe there may be a solution, however. A close gym leader colleague of mine, Vera, will be passing over Amari at some point soon. If I call in favor with her, maybe she'll be able to give you and your friends a lift to Cecilia. Or Celia. I think it's Celia. Probably Celia. I'm saying Cecilia, but I think it's Celia. It wouldn't exactly be five-star transportation, but it's better than nothing. However, as I'm sure you can appreciate, favors do not come for free. First, you would have to do something for me. You see, there are rumors spreading across the island. Have you heard of the Weeping Hill? It is like a burial mound for people and Pokemon alike. And lately, many mysterious things have occurred there. Many, well, supernatural things. I don't typically entertain myself with the idea of paranormal occurrences, yet the whole idea of a supernatural threat has put the city on edge. The result? People aren't doing the jobs required to sustain Celeste. Things are most certainly falling apart. That, in addition to the rumblings of Team Crescent, is enough to put any gym leader on edge. So Sora, that's where you come in. I have a favor to ask. I would like you to travel to the Weeping Hill and explore the ruins beneath the surface. I would like you to find the source of these supernatural sightings and remove it. In exchange, I'll see to it that Vera will transport you and your friends to Celia. Is that fair? Excellent. I'll let the guard know that you have permission to enter the burial grounds. You can find Weeping Hill on Route 2, just south of here. Be careful, yes? I have learned to not take even the slightest rumor lightly. Fair enough. I got a bad habit of making other people's problems my problems. Huh? Well, we rolled our face on everything we could have, so. What the? Spooky. Galarian Yamask. Rune Grigas. Hey, what you doing up there, sir? Why has he got a grave? Nova. Oh, they both have graves. That's kind of crazy. Boo. You really take me for one of those spooky little apparitions. Oh, please. Have I ever looked so dressy or dreary? I suppose you're wondering what I'm doing in a place like this, then. Not really. You kind of seem like the type of person that frequents places like this. I'd say I'm visiting a French grave, but you probably wouldn't believe me. Weeping Hill is, of course, more than a common graveyard. Far more, in fact. Rumor has it that Weeping Hill can physically retell an individual's memories to other travelers by using the ghostly mist. Of course, that would explain all the floaty faces scurrying about. I've heard that it can appear far more realistic to some. Be on guard. Oh yes, confusing indeed. I wonder, tell me, Sora, what did you see in the mist? You saw two young boys battling? That's very curious, but I'm not all that surprised. You continue to pique my interest, Sora. Anyway, on to business. This entrance leads to the Weeping Depths. You'll find that the illusions are a lot more noticeable down there. Who knows what you may find? I didn't exactly answer the question as to why I'm here, did I? I'm after something, Sora. I'm looking for a particular object that I believe can be, well, unlocked down here. A stone, to be precise. Who knows with your talents, you may find it before I do. Interesting. There's all this damn blood in the cave. Wait a moment, would you? I feel something in the air. Those boys. Why am I not surprised? Do you remember my explanation of Weeping Hill and how it presents an individual's memories? Well, Sora, let me be an example to you. That memory was mine. One of those boys was my younger brother, Keegan. The other, the long-haired one, was myself. Things used to be so much simpler then. Keegan wasn't exactly the best fighter or the best anything for that matter. Calling him my brother was an insult in itself. Damn, dude, that's rough. As my family had no room for weakness or failure. Of course, with me being his brother, it didn't take long for his jealousy to set in. Not that I blame him. He never really caught up in the end, truth be told. In fact, he was pretty much forgotten whenever he was by my side. Enough of that, I suppose. Let's move on, shall we? Come on, there's a special sanctuary down here. I would be most curious to show you more, Sora. However, you will find the deeper caves of the hill to be quite the maze. You'd be wise to watch your step. Hello? It's supposed to be a maze. In before the hint is follow the blood. The things that we're seeing, do you think they're ghosts? Oh, so spooky, right? They look like outlines of people, you know? Maybe they are ghosts. Or are you scared? I'm not even surprised. Hey, we're in the middle of a mass graveyard. I wouldn't be surprised if there were ghosts down here. You'd have to be stupid to not be scared. Well, we've got a job to do, so get over it, wimp. Supernatural stuff is a load of bull anyway. Come on, grow up. Have you not seen, like, the pools of dried up blood everywhere? What do you suppose that's from? The burials too? Nah, that's probably from my ears, to be honest. Listening to you all day is really taking a toll. Now hurry up, we're late. Everyone else will be already in there, so let's go. I'm not a wimp, damn it. She's just saying that to cover up how scared she is. This group is such rubbish sometimes. What the? Hey, you! Get out of here now! Oh, damn. You don't look like a trainer to me, or a ghost for that matter. You're just an ordinary civilian. Why are you down here anyway? It's not safe for people like you. Whatever. I'm sorry, but I got a job to do. But ah, oh, we're in cave. Boom. 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 Earth power. Oh. Ah, you son of a bitch. Ah, that's some bullshit. What? How'd you beat me? Aren't you just a basic trainer? Oh man, I don't know about this anymore. If I can't beat you, how am I supposed to look after myself down there? Some people say those ghosts become more realistic as you go deeper. I'm not cut out for that. No way. Good luck with whatever it is you're doing. I'm out of here. Okay. That's some pretty bitch-made energy, not gonna lie. Meanwhile. Come on, Mincino. One more move, and we finally got him. Oh, please. As if it were that easy. Yes! Damn it. We did it, Mincino. We finally did it. We beat him, and it's all thanks to you. Well, celebrate while you can, I guess. You're not half bad, at least. That's a funny way of admitting you lost. Yeah, well, you're lucky. I was going easy on you. It was just training, after all. You're gonna have to do better than that if you want a gym badge. Hey, well, if Sora did it, there's no reason I can't. That's what training's for, right? Come on. Everyone knows that was a fluke. It's not like I had my actual team. You spend a lot of time moping, you know that, right? You know, no gym leaders depended on someone else telling them that they're strong. You don't need anyone else's validation. Not everyone can become a gym leader after all. Are you trying to, like, give me a pep talk? Listen up, I don't need anyone telling me any. You're doing it again. Just take the compliment, okay? Whatever. You and your friends are totally insufferable. I can never be more relieved to be almost out of here. Huh? Out of here? Wait, you're leaving? You're not coming with us? Yeah, no. You lot barely have a plan to get to Celia, as it is. And at this rate, you'll be flying Arden's Pokemon over there. And to be honest, I wouldn't even put that past her. I don't know if you've realized, but this whole thing is ridiculous even if that's the plan. You're welcome to throw your lives away, but I'd rather find my own way to Celia. Even if it means going through Blackview and seeing her. So you're scared of the dark and scared of heights, huh? For someone who pretends to be so tough, you sure have a lot of weaknesses. You talk a lot for someone who's only been battling for, what, a couple days? But I don't know. I suppose I'm still glad I met you. I didn't realize I could be, you know, a decent teacher or something. So, you know, you're not half bad. Are you trying to be nice? Shut up. Don't make it weird. Hey, I'm just joking. Honestly, thanks. Without you teaching me the battle, I definitely wouldn't be able to look after myself. I'd still just be dragging down Ava and Sora, you know? I owe you a lot, Connor. But hey, don't act like this is goodbye. We'll all end up in Celia after all. I suppose you're right. I could use a longer hiatus from Ava, but we'll see what happens. Whatever the case, we spent enough time sitting around, right? Your friends are probably waiting for you after all. I suppose you're right. Hey, good luck out there, yeah? Like I'll need it. Well, later, Scarlet. Hey, Connor, wait. You remember what I told you about Vyer and Ava? That girl, the one with those weird powers after she saved Ava, she told me something. She said that if I made the right choices, I'd be able to, you know, change the world. I could end all the conflict, all of the suffering in Irith. I thought it was just figurative, but something felt off. She was talking specifically to me, after all. I don't know. I've just been thinking a lot about it. Maybe I'm meant to find her again or something. Maybe there's something more I'm meant to do. I don't know, Scarlet. It all sounds like nonsense to me. I don't think any of us are special enough to change the world. This place is far too messed up for that. The best we can do is look after ourselves. That Nova person, she's clearly fooled herself, but don't let her fool you too. You're not special, Scarlet. None of us are. If we were, it just put a target on our back. It'll take more than a motley group of half-rate trainers to solve all the problems Irith faces. You really think we have no hope of changing things? There's nothing more wasteful than blind, unfounded hope, Scarlet. You saw what Faith does to people. Just look at Kenneth. Just take care of yourself, Scarlet. Okay. My, bro, I took like 2 fucking steps. What do we have here? I didn't expect to see you here, that's for sure. Although, I should say that I'm surprised at this point. Ugh, fuck. If it isn't Sora, all alone in the depths of the Weeping Hill, how curious. Perhaps what I saw in you was correct all along. But if you were here at the same time as Shiv, then... I see. So I suspected you must be working together. Despite my best warning, Shiv got to you first. That's unfortunate. Whatever the case, actually I'm here for a fucking ranger side quest. I don't know what the fuck he's doing here. Whatever the case, I have a feeling that you have your wits about you, Sora. So know this. Keeping your distance from Shiv is the only way to stay safe. After everything he has done, you don't want to be involved with him in any capacity. Not unless you have a death wishes, of course. Well, I'm going to say this right now. I really can't stand Pokemon fan game names. A lot of time, they beat you over the head with somebody's fucking name. That dude's name is fucking Shiv. This chick's name is Nova. God, dude. Come on. That could be a little more tact. Like, how about Mart? He would seem significantly less threatening. But it's also not as cringeworthy as fucking Shiv. God. I digress. It's not really that important, but fuck them names. Well, if I'm asking you to trust me instead of Shiv, then I have some catching up to do, right? Of course, how can you trust me when you don't know anything about me? Fine, let's start again. As you know, I am Nova. I don't really care, but, you know, at this point, I'm convinced that since this is a part of the trio of Pokemon Rejuvenation and Reborn, this is pretty much just me clicking X Simulator. I'm well and reading the fucking onslaught of dialogue. I'm a member of Team Crescent. Oh, no. Come on, Sora. Of course you got the impression that we're villains or something. I mean, Baron may be a villain, sure. No one can control what the fool does or says, but the rest of us were different. I understand that the incident with Ava, it may have given you the wrong impression, but you need to at least hear us out, just once. Crescent may be a criminal organization, sure, but our values, our aspirations, they're noble. We're good people, Sora, all of us. And ultimately, we all share the same goal. We just want things to be better, you know? Peace, prosperity, happiness, throwing people into volcanoes. We want to create a world where people can live freely without suffering or loss. A world that, by natural means, is but a fleeting fantasy. Can you imagine such a thing, Sora? Can you see it? No, because it sounds completely asinine. Probably not. To the average bystander, such goals must border on insanity. They do. But once you hear our idea and our grand plan, Perhaps you will see things our way. Of course, I can't ignore the fact that you came here with Shiv. I would seem that he's gained your trust, at least to some degree. And if that's the case, you clearly have no idea who he is. Perhaps then, by following him throughout these depths, you'll see who he truly is. You can see his own memories, after all. That way, you'll see that Shiv is the monster, not us. Perhaps after you see the world that Shiv has destroyed, you may be more entertained by the one I wish to create. After all, the power to forge this new world, it's for anyone to take. Let's see how this pans out. Thank God. Fuck. I can't wait. Oh my. Oh, that's so bad. I was worried, like, somebody else was gonna show up and start fucking talking. An Ivysaur. Ah, shite. No. Oh. Oh, hey! Ah, that's pretty unfair, gotta say. He's always one step ahead, but my training, my Pokemon, this time I'll win, right? Probably not. I have to read these, or at least attempt to. At least I think I do. Only in the Pokemon world could you be chilling out with literal ghosts. Rockana. No, no, they can't be. They are literal ghosts, my man. This place gives me the creeps. Shit. Don't poison me, you bitch. Oh, okay, thank you. Dungu. Oh, for fuck's sake. I hate field effects. Down two Pokemon, could use a heal. Ha! I played myself. I think the dodge is perfect. Old doll. Okay. How did I get that right on the second try? That's kind of nuts. I wonder if this is like the Lieutenant Surge gym puzzle. Thank you. Jeez, okay, hold up. You know, fuck it. It wasn't enough. I never will be. His powers. I wish I had at least something. Do I run? Start over? Without him, I'll be nothing. That's tough. Keegan really was a waste of space in my mind. I suppose he just wanted recognition or something. At the time, I didn't really care. Truth be told, even now, it's of no consequence. I'm getting ahead of myself again. You're probably wondering why this is all so important. After all, the nonsense with my younger brother is of no concern to anybody. Listen closely, Sora. At the time of the incident with Keegan, I had unearthed something, very important. Something of a very personal significance to me. At the time, it was a simple stone, unremarkable besides its dark color and glowing accents. Now, however, I have become more aware of its true nature. That stone is, of course, the Onyx Stone. Yes, the same Onyx Stone that those Crescent lackeys seek. You may be wondering why everyone wishes to come in possession of such a stone. Well, the answer isn't exactly straightforward. No one knows with certainty what the stone does, but everyone has their theories. It is commonly believed that the stone is capable of communicating with a powerful legendary Pokemon. Oh, excuse me. Ooh. To have a legendary Pokemon in your possession at your disposal, the opportunities are limitless. Of course, no one should control such power. Naturally, I was unable to solve the secrets of the stone when I first came to possess it, so I locked it away where no one would find it. Here in this very graveyard within a memory. The Weeping Hills is, after all, an endless vault of memories. It was my belief that no one would be able to access it here. Not without me, of course. Yet recently, I have felt some disclosures within my memories. Something feels wrong, as though I can feel somebody else peering through the cracks. That feeling, in conjunction with Crescent's growing presence here, has led me to believe that the stone is no longer safe. So now the time has come to bring it back into my possession. At least we know why he's fighting here. How does this fantastical tale concern you, however? Well, the problem is I can't reach the stone alone. For one reason or another, many of my memories feel shut off or incomplete. I feel like my own past is riddled in mysteries, even to me. Much of my past life, my past experience, they're no longer privy to me, Sora. I need someone else to access the memories where I stored the Onyx Stone and return it to me. If you don't succeed, then Crescent will, and the result of that would be truly catastrophic. That's why I need you to find it before they do. You may be confused by all this, but I just need you to listen carefully. Using my abilities, I should be able to transport you to the memory where I believe the Onyx Stone is hidden. Within this memory, you will find yourself within my old manor, during the time in which Keegan chose to leave my company. I don't know where the Onyx Stone is within the manor, but I trust that you can find it. Now come. Now I believe this spot should do the trick. It's time to go, Sora. Now this shouldn't hurt, but I can't tell you that traveling through another's memories isn't, well, uncomfortable. Good luck, I suppose. You might need it, actually. Time. What the fuck? Keegan, for the last time, I don't have to battle you. I'm immensely busy, far more important matters, and you know that. I'm sure I'll find the time to train with you at some point. Just be patient, would you? Be patient, seriously? Oh, fuck, bro, I'm gonna have to read all this shit. I thought this was a side quest episode. I thought I was just gonna just run around, do some quests, but no. I got my fucking essay ready. Ugh. Crap. After all this time, you're still just as arrogant. We used to train together every day. Now, after all your winning, all of your dumb rewards, you don't hang out with any of us anymore. You're just a self-absorbed loser. Whatever. I expected more from you, Keegan. Such a perspective is purely and unequivocally childish. Isn't he like a child? What the fuck? Look at you compared to him. What? Fine, I'll prove it to you. I'll prove to you that you're not invincible, that you can't just pretend none of us exist. One more battleship. If I win, you'll start treating me with respect. If I lose, then you can do whatever the hell you want. A bit dramatic, don't you think? Just battle me, Shiv. One last time. Fine, Keegan. One last battle, and then you leave me alone. Don't come whining to me when you lose again. Well, well, look who made it to the party. Oh, fuck, bro. Go away! I just spoke to you! So surely at this point you started to see Shiv for who he really is. I mean, no. This is like nothing. I don't know anything about this guy. This is like one scene. What did I tell you, Sora? He's the monster. He manipulates people to do his bidding. I have literally not seen enough to run into that conclusion at all. Go away. Charms them until he has no more use for them. Look at how he treated his younger brother. What he did to Kenem Village. He didn't do shit to Kenem Village. He stopped them. Unless I'm misremembering how the fuck that happened. Even beyond what you've seen, his atrocities are countless. I don't doubt it, but let me see him first. So then I ask you this. Why do you trust him? I fucking don't, but I got literally nothing else to do. Why do you do as he bids, even knowing that he'll simply cast you aside when he's done with you? Take a look around, Sora. This must be Shiv's home, from a memory long past. If he sent you here, it must be to claim that same object that I seek, the Onyx Stone. So I suppose that puts you at an impasse, huh? You'd go through with his plan and bring him the Onyx Stone, or you could put up your faith in me and the world that I envision. We could do this, Sora, together. Just think about it, would you? What? Wait, do I have the... Did I just... Interesting. Okay. Very... Okay, but are my Pokemon still follow up? Yeah? Okay, fair enough. There's a random ass tree in this manor. Oh, Keegan, you fool. I warned you. Now look what you've done. He's always given this family a bad name, diluted its power, its purity. Perhaps putting him in his place was for the best. If he had powers like us, things could have gone differently. But reality is never so forgiving. Did you kill him or something? What the fuck? Let's go read the books. I lost. It's all over. What is there left for me to do? Shiv would never understand. Not when I'm so different, so useless. Maybe I should have just run away. I could make him realize how totally alone he is without me. I could find new people, new friends, people who wouldn't throw me away like Shiv. I'll tell him I'm leaving and he'll be horrified. He'll beg for me to stay. Shiv's house is quite the mess, isn't it? Yet in this period of time, his life was almost perfect. I suspect the truth is more sinister. The memory itself is in the state of collapse. For Shiv himself to be in such a state, you must wonder what is happening behind the scenes. Like all the others that have crossed Shiv, Shiv himself is falling apart. Don't let this desperation fool you, Sora. Shiv, it's me. I want to talk. Keegan, I'm sure you can tell how busy I am. I won our battle, so I have no business with you. I have something to tell you, Shiv. It's important. To you, every little thing is important. Please, it's embarrassing. You need to check your priorities, little brother. This stone, it's different. It yields some kind of power that may change everything for all of humanity. It's more important than the both of us. To ignore its power, its importance would be beyond selfish. What are you talking about? To you, every little rock, every little relic is more important than the both of us. I don't believe any of it, Shiv. Are you telling me that you'd value that dumb rock over me, over my life? You. Damn it. Why should I even be surprised? Listen, Shiv. I'm done. I'm over all of it. I'm leaving this stupid manor. I'm living your dumb narcissistic life. I want to start over and make new friends. I want to find new trainers and new people that believe in me more than you do. And you'll be alone here. Fine. If that's what you wish, then go ahead. I'm not stopping you. Wait, what? You're not going to beg me to stay? Why would I? You're foolish, Keegan. I don't care for this petty fantasy of yours. Without the powers that I have, you'll always be a stain upon this family. A normal life suits you far more than whatever's following me would have had it in store for you. But go on, Keegan. I have no more use for you. Now, if that's all, I have work to do. Fine. Have it your way. From here on out, I'm starting a new life, one without the likes of you. New friends, new Pokemon, a new life, and a new name. Kuiki. Aww. I'll be called Kuiki. That's tough. Farewell, Shiv. Been a week since my brother left, and still nothing. This stone continues to elude me. What secrets does it hold? How many months must this stone steal from me? How many methods must I try? I know this stone is special. I know it's holding something from me, but perhaps. Am I losing myself along the way? Kuiki, you fool. Of course, even in absence, you continue to sully our name. How embarrassing. Maybe it's time I dealt with you for good. Left you somewhere where nobody would find you. Where the years will pass and at a speed beyond your measure. The ways I can focus on what really matters. Uncovering these secrets, no matter how long it takes. Okay, we got it. Oh, Sora, you're back. Oh my god, this chick needs to go away. So you've seen through the truth, dude. The origin of Kuiki and his eventual demise. When Kuiki outgrew his use, Shiv cast him out into the world with almost nothing at his side. For Kuiki, that was almost certainly a death sentence. He abandoned him, Sora. But even that wasn't enough for Shiv. Once Kuiki found himself in murky waters and cited that Shiv was his brother in order to get out of trouble, Shiv chose to value his reputation over his own brother. He took Kuiki and cast him into what is now called the grid. He left him at the highest levels of the grid, where time is accelerated far beyond our understanding. Shiv, the saint that he is, was unable to kill his brother, so instead he gave him a fate worse than death. He left him isolated, alone, to live out his days in solitude until he was meant to eventually die. Shiv, he is a monster, Sora, not us. The evidence is there. Now it's up to you to make the right decision. Hand me the Onyx Stone before Shiv does to you what he did to you. Sora, can you hear me? Ah, I see you finally got the Onyx Stone. I knew I was right to count on you. Well then, let's get to work, shall we? Damn it. Listen to me, Sora. You can't trust him. He's... Welcome back, Sora. Sorry about all that. I'm going into someone's memories like that. It's not exactly fun for anybody. No hard feelings, right? Anyway, on to business. I suppose you got the stone for me. Of course you have. I knew I could count on you, Sora. As I suspected, you truly are different. Come on, follow me. What the fuck? So, do I have a choice in who I give this to, or can I keep it? What's happening? Alright, Sora. We're here. Would you bring me the stone? Come on, don't dawdle. Not so fast. Alright, here's the moment. Sora, please, before you give him the stone, think about everything he has done. Please, you can't trust Shiv. The Onyx Stone is too powerful to be held by someone like him. Nova, I should have figured it was you. I felt meddling in these affairs. It's been a while, Or perhaps not seeing you as you meddle with Kuiki as well. Kuiki was your misstep, Shiv, not mine. Of course you'd say that. I wouldn't be surprised if all of this was your doing, truth be told. I don't suppose Sora knows that you're a member of Team Crescent. I told her the truth, Shiv. Every bit of it. Unlike you, I was honest, sincere. I told them about our goal, our new world, everything. I bet you did. You must have talked at lengths of how noble and how passionate you are, of how much you want to save the world. Oh, please. Did you perhaps share how you plan on accomplishing such a fantastical feat? Sora knows about the Onyx Stone, Shiv. Yet I suspect you have shared nothing of your intended use for it. Let me enlighten you, Sora. I don't suppose you heard of the mythical Pokemon capable of controlling nightmares. His name, of course, is Darkrai. Okay, at least we're getting to the point, right? Like, you know, Pokemon Rejuvenation over here worshiping Xerneas for taking literally 8 years to ever mention the Pokemon. Meanwhile, fucking Arceus is all over the damn art. You know, Pokemon Reborn is, well, whatever it is, but... There are rumors of special, more powerful Darkrai hidden somewhere in an Irith Irith or beyond capable of inflicting an endless dream on any person or Pokemon it sees fit. Through my years of study, numerous legends speak of Darkrai putting entire villages to sleep using its power. Some of us believe that with the Onyx Stone, one might be capable of reaching an audience with Darkrai. Yet who knows? It's all legend after all. Typical for Crescent to be so immersed in nothing more than folklore. Of course, Team Crescent intends on using the stone to find Darkrai and somehow bend it to their will. With that in mind, they would be capable of creating an endless dream where they sit at the throne, forged by their own hands, forever. Is that right, Nova? Yeah, it is. A dream without violence, without bloodshed, a dream where everyone lives happily. A world that is only achievable through our means, Sora. Is that not something you're fighting for? How predictable. Your words, however sweet, are riddled with poison. You may think you can fool Sora, but you will never fool me. You betrayed me once before, after all. Wake up, Nova. A dream is a dream. Reality must be accepted no matter how harsh it is. You can't run away from your problems by embracing petty dreams. Only through perseverance, determination, and grit can you free yourself from the problems of this world. Putting the... fuck, dude. These two waxing philosophical at each other for the last 30 minutes. Putting the entire world under the shadow of a dream would save no one. This world is sick, Sora. I spent all this time convincing you of that. Think of all that you have encountered. Kenneth, the incident with your friend, the Black Foxes. Bro, it's been like a day. What are you talking about? I mean, yeah, a lot has happened in like the span of a day, but I mean, like, that doesn't necessarily speak to a lifetime. And your ass is over here trying to convince me to revolutionize the world. Yeah, he's a piece of shit, but what you're saying could lead to the deaths of billions of people. What the fuck does changing the world mean? What does that mean to you? What does the world have to look like? Okay, it's a world with no pain and no suffering. What does that look like? How are we achieving that? You got some questions I need to hear. Otherwise, I mean, I keep this fucking stone and walk out this goddamn door, but I don't think that's an option here. Something tells me I'm gonna have to pick and piss one off. With Darkrai at our side, we can stop all of it. People don't have to suffer anymore, Sora. Yeah, see, look, that sounds like you're just gonna brainwash a bunch of fucking people. Shiv, he can't be trusted. Neither could you. Just think, Sora. Who knows what he would do with Darkrai at his side? Sora, if you can't trust my words, then perhaps you'll trust my feelings. Let me show you. By battling you with my Pokemon at my side, you can feel my ideals, my values, everything. When it's time to make your choice, you'll know what to do. I want this world to be a better place, Sora. So show me what you want. What the fuck? Fire, its intensity. Do you understand yet? Do you see, Sora? The bond that trainers gain from a battle. You know you can trust me. So please, hand me the stone. What theoretical nonsense? I needn't go to such ridiculous length to get the truth across. Sora's intelligent enough. I trust that you will make the right decision. So Sora, what will it be? Would you rather give the stone to Nova and embrace a silly dream, or would you give the stone to me so it can be destroyed? Do I have to make a choice here? Shit. I mean, like, the problem with Nova is that, like, she did save Ava. So, yeah. The problem with it is when I take all of that off the table, right? I don't know what his crazy ass wants to do with the stone. But I do know, like, what she wants to do with the stone just doesn't make any fucking sense. Yes, you want to make a world full of world peace and happiness. I think in an ideal world, that's nice, but how the fuck are you, do you mean to go about that? It's just, it seems so flawed. And then I have, I gotta go with this guy. Just because her idea of what to do with the stone is just stupid. And I don't know what he wants to do with it, though. But, I mean, he does seem like a pretty shitty person, all things considered. Honestly, I feel like keeping it should have been a play, but... Good choice, Sora. It's nice to see that I can rely on you. And it's good to know that you've got a clear head. No, but this is for the best. My sincerest apologies. Farewell. Oh, no, you don't. No. I know you don't believe in our cause yet, Sora, but in time you will. Our new world... Well, that was kind of a fucking... Oh, God, I hate how pointless... That was literally pointless. Our new world. You can reign with us at the top if you only let yourself. Damn it. She stole it. That foolish wench. I'll remember that you aided me today, Sora, but for now, I have to stop her. Kian. Return to the surface. Oh, Sora, looking on over for you. Why didn't you tell us where you went off to? Look, Arden said she'd finalize the plan to get us back to Celia. I don't want to spend any more time messing around, so let's move on, yeah? I mean, I have bad news for you. I still got side quests to do. Pokemon messed up. Still got a whole few more we gotta do. Man of the Sea? Oh, I have to do the... Oh, I need to do the gym battle to do this one. Okay, fair enough. Fudge. Here to get this toad is up here. There it is. stay in the ball heat more. Okay, that's two down. We did return my little monkey. Remind Floyd of your agreement. Oh, I have to find that book at that place. It's a rogue Venusaur on Route 1. Can I catch it? Probably fucking not. Would be very surprised if they let me... Nah, I can't catch this damn thing. Where are you, Venus? There you are. Expected it to be way stronger. Okay. The Venusaur is down. Defeat the ruler of the sky? What is that? Can't do that. I have to do all the route to ranger quests in order for me to do this one in particular, so I actually can't do it. Interesting. Smoochum. Alright, we still got a few less. Ruler of the sky we cannot do. Not ruler of the sky, wait. Okay, so I just gotta do the gym battle. Fuck it. Alright. Before I can do the rest of these. The gym battle is kind of just gatekeeping quite a few of these. But that's fine. I don't think it's that big a deal. Anyways, that's going to be it for the episode, guys. If you guys are enjoying this playthrough, please leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe for more. And I will see you guys next time. Until then, take care and bye. play, please leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe for more. Until then, have a good one.